the exposed, rugged terrain of the Brecon Beacons make this the ideal place for British soldiers to prepare for fighting on the front line. But why did two soldiers die here without even facing the enemy? So far, the MOD has only released this brief statement. It is with great sadness that the Ministry of Defence can confirm the death of Lance Corporal Craig Roberts and another Army Reserve soldier during a training exercise in the Brecon Beacons at the weekend. Our thoughts are with their families and friends at this difficult time. It was the hottest day of the year, and they were reportedly trying out for the SAS branch of the TA. Chris Hunter is a former Special Forces officer who regularly trained here.
They've got to continually refuel their body, you know, get lots of fluids inside them, get salts inside them, and then they've got to use the layer system where they're stripping off layers when they get hot, putting them back on as they start to cool down again. And all of this is being done under a very tight time constraint, carrying very, very heavy amounts of equipment and ultimately trying to cross that finish line, you know, accurately navigating themselves from A to B.
The group were training near Penny Van, the highest peak in South Wales.
It's tough going just walking up here on a warm day, but on Saturday it was even hotter, nearly 30 degrees, and the soldiers would have been wearing full uniform, carrying guns and equipment, weighing up to 22 kilograms, that's 3.5 stone, and all while being put through their paces on a grueling physical exercise.
They would have been warned to take plenty of water, and medics should have been on the route. But questions are being asked about whether it was safe to go ahead during a heat wave.
Well, it's essential that the British Army does not reduce its standards and lower the challenge and the difficulty of training. It's important to press people to their limits, because if you don't, if you do make training easier, then it makes it that much harder to fight in wars, and it may well be easier for the soldiers in training, but it potentially risks much greater casualty levels.
A third soldier is in a serious condition in hospital. Both the police and the Ministry of Defence are investigating. The MOD says there are currently no plans to change any routine military training.